every time I come and wake them up, they get the zoomies. They get so excited. Hi, babies. Hello. Here. So cute. You're so cute. Here we go. Water nozzle. Gotta teach them to use the water nozzle because there's no mama here to show them. Oh, see that black one? That black one's a little more with it. Look at her. That's my keeper. Look at him. Attack the source.
Feeding them like this was proving to be somewhat difficult and time-consuming, because the bigger and stronger they got, the more they started to scrap over the tip of the dropper. At one point, I even tried to operate multiple droppers at once, but it just wasn't feasible with only two hands, so I had to come up with another way.
See, that's why it's actually easier to take a couple pieces of bread, saturate it good in there, get it nice and doughy. This is how they've been putting on a lot of weight, because bread is very highly digestible. So do that. I'll take all their stuff out because they make a god awful mess. I gotta change the paper anyway. Go.
I should probably mention that I didn't start using the bread until after all the babies have opened their eyes and they began to nibble on things. Now, because these guys were stunted and underdeveloped when this whole thing started, it was right around 4 weeks. At first I tried using a sponge, but that didn't really work because the liquid would get absorbed all the way into the sponge, as sponges do, but then the babies wouldn't be able to suck it all out. Then I tried cutting the sponge, but I didn't like the way the frayed edges looked. Definitely not with these babies' growing teeth. Using the bread turned out to be super effective, because I didn't have to worry about them ingesting any part of it. And since the bread can only absorb but so much fluid, they were able to get a lot more milk out of it. The downside being that it makes a total mess.
It's bath time for the babies. This dirtiness is from them. They were filthy. They were just all in their food.
At first, cleanup involved me wiping each one down by hand with a toothbrush and a washcloth. At the point you see here, they've already begun individual grooming. Now, this update should have actually been posted last week, so as of right now, they have started social grooming as well. So bath times are no longer necessary. I'll be posting last and this week's videos back to back. So be sure to like, subscribe, and follow Minion Museum Reptiles on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and now on TikTok.